وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى in today's contradiction I want to speak about something that you find many people fall into and it's a very dangerous thing which is to indulge into memorizing statements of scholars or memorizing poetry and abandoning memorizing the Qur'an. So this is something I myself have been thinking about for a very long time, contemplating and pondering over it. So it's me trying to share with you something that I critique myself for as well and that I want all of us to, inshallah ta'ala, look into whether we fall into it, bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. By the way, these contradictions, as I've mentioned before, it's not me telling you guys that you're contradicting in something that you're saying or doing. It is also myself. I'm also talking to myself. And it's things that I've seen from myself as well. And also things that I've seen from other people. So even if I don't name it, or I don't put a name to some of the contradictions that I'm going to mention, I believe I'm the first person to fall into it. So may Allah give us subhanahu wa ta'ala istiqamah. And make us steadfast. إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ And this journey, brothers and sisters, that we are taking, we're all in it together. We're all in it together. And there's no hierarchy here. There isn't me and then you guys all listeners. Rather, it is all of us together as brothers and also as sisters, trying to tread on that path to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala that He doesn't forsake us and that He doesn't hold us account for everything, mistakes and shortcomings that we've come with. And that if He gives us, إِنَّهُ وَلِيُّ ذَلِكَ وَالْقَادِرُ عَلَيْهِ Allah has the ability to do so. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here I want to speak about something that I've been thinking about, I've been pondering over, which is memorizing statements, poetry, you know, the statements of people, human beings, even though they're scholars, great imams of Islam, on the expense of the Qur'an. And Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, he has a chapter in his Sahih, in Kitab al-Adab. There's a chapter where he says, بَابُ مَا يُكْرَهُ أَن يَكُونَ الْغَالِبُ عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ الشِّعْرُ حَتَّى يَصُدَّهُ عَن ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَالْعِلْمِ وَالْقُرْآنِ Bukhari rahimahullah, he says, the chapter where it's disliked, أَن يَكُونَ الْغَالِبُ عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ that the person is overcome by, the majority of what he does is الشِّعْرُ, poetry. حَتَّى يَصُدَّهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ until it returns him away from the remembrance of Allah. وَالْعِلْمِ وَالْقُرْآنِ and it turns him away from knowledge and the Qur'an. So, memorizing poetry of the ulama will fall under there. Yani if the Qur'an is being abandoned, the statement of a scholar is lower than the Qur'an. لَا شَكَّ وَلَا رَيْبٍ Then what do you think the poetry that you created or you writ? Some people, they write their own poetries. And they call it spoken words, or they call it poetry, or some even call it anashid islamiyya, they call it. And they memorize it. They will do it in the front of a stage. They memorize their own words that they've writ. They memorize their, yani some of them have written ample yani poetries, and they've memorized it all. Like in the Quran, they've forsaken it. They've never memorized the Quran. And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, and Imam al-Bukhari also brought that under that chaptering in his Sahih. He brought under the chaptering Hadith Abu Huraira, and he also found in Sahih Muslim as well, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لِأَنْ يَمْتَلِئَ جَوْفُ رَجُلٍ قَيْحًا يَرِيهِ خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَنْ يَمْتَلِئَ شِعْرًا The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it is better for any one of you that inside of his body be filled with pus, which may consume his body, than it being filled with poetry. The Prophet here, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is saying, لِأَنْ يَمْتَلِئَ جَوْفُ رَجُلٍ جَوْفٍ here means the inside of a person, to be filled up with قَيْحًا means pus. يريه خير من أن يمتلئ الشعرا. It is يعني to be for a person's body to be filled up with pus is actually, and he consumes it, his body consumes it, it is better than him to be filled with poetry. Now here it means the poetry, because Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala, when he brought it under a chaptering. And Bukhari rahimahullah is trying to prove the understanding of the hadith. Bukhari rahimahullah's chapterings are his fiqh, his views and his opinions. So here he's trying to extract from it, rahimahullah ta'ala, which is بَابُ مَا يُكْرَهُ أَن يَكُونَ الْغَالِبُ عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ الشِّعْرُ حَتَّى يَصُدَّوْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَالْعِلْمِ وَالْقُرْآنِ. That the poetry or what you're memorizing, it doesn't block you from, it doesn't become a hindrance or an obstacle in the Qur'an and the remembrance of Allah and the knowledge. And that's so important, brothers and sisters. You're contradicting yourself. Or you're saying, my memorization is very weak. I can't memorize. I can't. But you're memorizing unnecessary stuff. But when it comes to the Qur'an, you're not memorizing. It's a contradiction. It's a contradiction. And the first thing that we should give importance to, brothers and sisters, when it comes to memorizing is the Qur'an. And everything else is secondary. It comes second place. It comes what? It comes second place. وَلِذَلِكَ الْإِمَامُ الْأَوْزَاعِيُّ إِمَامُ أَهْلِ الشَّامِ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ رَحْمَةً وَاسِعًا. It was said that if a young child came in his halaqa, he would say to that child, have you memorized the Qur'an? And if he says, yes, I have memorized the Qur'an, he wouldn't just take his word for it. He would test him. And he would ask him the ayat, such as the narration mentions, as يُوصِيكُمُ اللَّهُ فِي أَوْلَادِكُمْ وَلَكُمْ نِصْفُ مَا تَرَكَ يَسْتَفْتُونَكَ فِي النِّسَاءِ. Those verses which are ayat that talk about the inheritance. So he'd ask him about the ayat which are mutashabih, that can really tell the one who memorized and is alert. If that student or that young child or that young brother or sister, they've memorized it, they got it right, and Imam al-Awza'i rahimahullah, he wouldn't يعني, take them away from the halaqah, and he would allow them to benefit and study, because they're now ready to go to the next phase of memorizing a hadith and studying. But if that person had not memorized the Qur'an, and Imam al-Awza'i would say to them, go and memorize the Qur'an and come back. Go and memorize the Qur'an and come back. And this is something, brothers and sisters, that if I actually writ a book on it to compile the times that the Imams of al-Islam told the people to memorize the Qur'an first, I could come with a thick, big volume. I could gather a volume on this whole issue. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to conclude there. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdi, ashadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.